All right, here we are. Today we're going to be testing out the new Ferrari 296. I've been really looking forward to this car ever since they dropped it and they put it out there in the real world, out there in the mix. It's been looking pretty good, sounds pretty good. It's been getting pretty good results too. So I'm really curious to see how it drives on this game. So today we're going to drive it around Valencia. At the same time, I'm driving a new car with a new track. I'm going to do two things. I'm going to drive it on safe preset. I would do a drive on the aggressive preset and do the same changes, the little small changes that I did with the safe preset in regards to the brake pads and the fuel load and no changes to the tire pressure, and just see how it drives in comparison to the two. Because those are the two setups that most people are going to drive. They're going to drive the safe and they're going to drive the aggressive. So we'll just see how they are straight out the box. But right now we're just going to focus on this Ferrari 296 and just see how it drives. Let's go. All right, here we are in the Ferrari 296 here at Valencia. First time driving it. Online, they said the steering lock was 1,000, so I made the changes. It seemed kind of high, but we're just gonna try it out. We'll go out here on a safe setup. I'm not gonna make any changes to the PSI or anything like that because we're not aware of the tire physics or the physics models that have been updated. So we'll just go off of what we can see right now and just go from here. We'll go ahead and just jump right into it. Just see how it drives.
Your exit's clear. Don't
cross. Sounds pretty cool. The dash looks cool. Yes, force feedback is totally different. I've never driven on this track before. I'm kind of learning at the same time. Yes. It's a little oversteery. First time being in it. Steering goes light a little bit upon the deceleration. Sounds good. You can hear the blow off valve or the wastegate. You can hear the turbo spool. It's always fun trying to learn a new track in a new car. See how this straight line speed is. Felt pretty good. The car feels pretty pointed. Seems like once you get the right setup and kind of get used to the car, it seems like it will do exactly what you want it to do. Seems pretty planted because I made a good amount of mistakes so far and have not been punished for them. So it's just a hint, an oversteer, which I'm pretty sure there are some changes you could do to change that. Overall though, I do like the way it drives. Pretty sure you can really get it dialed in once you deal with the tire pressure. Tire pressures and traction control. off top, you can see this car has a lot of potential. Now, mind you, I didn't mess with the rear brakes, the front brakes, the brake pads. I didn't even mess with the fuel. I just put it on the safe and came out here. I love the way this car sounds, though, I'll tell you that much. I really love the way this car sounds. The fact that the car didn't really punish me too bad right there says a lot. Now, mind you, I'm only on a safe setup, so I am aware of that. The car is very responsive. It does exactly what you want it to do, it seems. Missed that turn again. No! Light damage on the front.
Yellow flag.
Alright. Let's go back to it. Let's try to change our fuel load as well as our front brakes. Let's just probably go to like 35. I believe the ECU map. See, that's the thing. I don't know about ECU maps. I don't know anything right now in this car. But we'll just save that for right now. Say 28 degrees. But so far, I'm really liking this car. Feels good. Feels a lot different than the other one. The physics overall, though, feel different. Brake balance is really high, 65.
Green flag, you're clear. The pit exit's clear. We need to get some heat into these brakes.
This car has like the perfect balance of, it's like the perfect balance of raw power and stability. A lot of times you don't get those two in the same category. Raw power and stability. No!
Severe damage at the front.
Yellow flag.
It's usually at the sacrifice.
Pit exit's clear.
It's usually at the sacrifice of point. Usually when you have raw power. When you have stability, you lack a little bit in the raw power category. Oh man, the turbo spool in this car. It really sounds good. It takes the bumps pretty good. Feels good. Feels pretty good over bumps. It'd be really nice to try it out at like Zolder or Imola. See how it does during the chicane. Took that bump like a champ.
Your last lap time was at 1:38.02. It's your best lap in this session.
Still trying to get the hang of this track and this car at the same time.
Sector on time is good.
car is not that tough to control. Has really good rotation.
Sector one is quick.
Pretty balanced. I know I'm probably about like 20 seconds off fast time compared to like Jardier or the other eSport drivers. But it feels pretty good.
Sector 2 time is okay.
I gotta figure that out. So I know my front right, according to the new physics, is probably off.
Sector 1 time's okay.
This car has a very beautiful sound. The engine note is gorgeous. Matches very well with the wastegate. And of course, induction noises.
Sector 2 is a tenth off your best.
Almost lost it there, but it wasn't too hard to gain control of it.
You've just done it.
I'm having to turn down the track control.
That's your fastest lap today. Sectors 1 and 3 are fast. Sector 2 is a tenth off your best. Sector 2 time is quick.
Yeah, I'm really gonna like this car.
You've just done it.
Remember, this is only the first car out of the three car pack, you know? I still got two other cars to try out, you know?
Sector 2 is 0.28, slower than your best. Sector 1 time is good.
This is my turn. Handles bumps pretty good. Let's see if we can push it. I'm gonna turn this traction control all the way down. Turn the ABS down to
0.06.
See what happens.
Off your best.
Okay, let's see what an aggressive setup is like. Put it on 30. ECU is the same.
The track temp is 99. The air temp is 83 Fahrenheit.
All right, so we're gonna see what this aggressive setup is like. Let's go from here. See what the difference is between the aggressive setup and the safe setup. Here we go.
Pit exit is clear. Don't cross the line. Your brakes are cold. We need to get some heat into them.
Aggressive setup, it requires a less steering input, so maybe the roll bar Instead of the last, the front. Or it could just be some changes to the camber or toe. Kind of twitchy.
Yellow flag.
It's a little twitchy on the aggressive too.
The incident's clear. Green flag.
Let's see if we can get a good lap in with the aggressive setup. Yeah. Aggressive setup is a little bit more twitchy. That was also the first lap. Let's take it a little slower. See what we can put together. So of course, as you would expect, the aggressive setup is a little less tame. A little bit more precision is going to be involved with the aggressive setup of the Ferrari. Less input, so you're going to have to be more smoother. On an aggressive setup, it does not like to decelerate while turning.
The lap time was at 1:37.17. That's your best lap in the session.
Of course, you can make your changes to the aggressive setup or the safe setup, but just fresh out of the box. That's what I'm seeing.
Good. Sector 1 is quick.
That was a lot better than the last lap.
That was at 136. Sector 4. Sector 3 is a tenth off your best. Sector 1 time's okay. Sector 2 is 0.6, off your best.
See what happens, we take the traction control down to 1. On the aggressive setup.
That's your quickest so far. Sector 1 is 0.26, slower than your best. Sector 2 time is quick. That lap was at 135.66. That's your fastest lap. Sector 2 and 3 are fast. Sector 1 is 0.26, off your best. Thank you.
All right, so overall, I like the Ferrari. I think it's a pretty beautiful car. It sounds good. The engine note sounds a whole lot better in comparison to the other Ferrari from the other update. I like the fact that you can hear what's going on more in the motor. In particular, the forced induction sound. I love the turbo. I love the spooling up of the turbo. I love hearing the wastegate. It's more enjoyable for the driver experience. In regards to performance, it feels very planted. Of course, the safe setup, it really is safe. It feels safe in comparison to the aggressive setup. The aggressive setup, it does want to fight you a little bit more, but then that could also be to your level of skill, is what I'm thinking. So of course, if your skill's a little higher than mine, you might have a different opinion on whether it's fighting you or not. But for me, I felt like it was fighting me a little bit, but that's normal when it comes to aggressive. But I think once you get used to it, you know, you'll feel more at home with it. Or at least I know I will. In regards to the setups, I didn't take too much time to kind of dial things in. I kind of kept it at a base. Had my rear brakes at one, my front brakes at one, and just went from there. Changed my fuel. I didn't mess with the ECU maps because actually at this point I really don't know what my ECU maps are supposed to be. But yeah, I just did basic things, and the car felt pretty good. I have not driven the Porsche nor the Lamb yet, so I can't really compare the other two. But I know right now the Ferrari, it scores high on my board right now. And based off of what I've seen online, a lot of people are loving the Ferrari as well. But I'll keep my opinions to myself until I, you know, drive all the other cars and I'm able to give a full comparison of whether I like the car or not in comparison to the other ones and where I would rate it, you know, in comparison to the other two. But I know for right now, I like the Ferrari. It drives good. It drives pretty planted. If I were to compare it, it's kind of like driving the Ferrari in iRacing, you know, the Ferrari Challenge. Those cars are usually the first ones you get right out of rookie, and they're really fun to drive. This one's really fun to drive. Another thing, when you let off the acceleration or like on a high-speed turn, well, when you let off the gas on a high-speed turn, it's kind of like the NSX in a sense that it wants to let loose of the rear. So it's kind of like you have to keep that foot planted. You have to keep some acceleration going when you're on a high-speed turn. That's one thing I can notice about the Ferrari. I haven't made any setup changes, but I just know straight out of the box, it's a nice car to drive. I could tell that it would be a pretty fun car to make setup changes with and learn from. It would be pretty fun. Now, that leads us into our next car that we're going to drive, which is the Porsche. Now, I'll save that for the next video.